Hello, here's Dr. Rajiv Gupta, the founder director of RT Laser Center. I have today with me Dr. Varun Singla, who is our consultant plastic surgeon. And today we would be talking about the various concerns and frequently asked questions about the hair transplant. Over to Dr. Varun Singla.
Hi, I'm Dr. Varun Singla, and I'm a plastic surgeon. And I'm here to talk about the frequently asked questions about hair transplant. We'll have a short Q&A session to alleviate your doubts about hair transplant.
So tell me, what all techniques you commonly suggest or use for hair transplants?
Actually, there's two major techniques for hair transplantation. One is FUE, which is a neo technique, and the other is FUT, that is follicular unit transplant, which is the older or the classical method. Both give good results, although plastic surgeons normally are more in favor of FUT.
What exactly are the distinct advantages of this particular FUT technique?
FUT is the classical technique and was the first described technique for hair transplant. It has the advantage that more of hair retain on the hair for a longer time in FUT as compared to FUE, which is a newer technique, and it is normally prescribed by people who are not exactly surgeons, as in dermatologists and all, who don't do surgical techniques and therefore advocate FUE. But as plastic surgeons, we are more in favor of FUT. We can do both techniques, but FUT is more preferred from our side.
Okay. So how long would be the downtime? How long the patient would need to take off?
We recommend around 1 week. That the patient takes a rest of about 1 week, and that is the time that the patient normally removes his dressing and can normally go to work.
Okay, the question which every patient asks, is it painful?
Not exactly. It is a little uncomfortable in the beginning when we are injecting the local anesthetic, but after a while the whole scalp become numb. You can only feel the pressure of us applying the hair and taking out the hair, but there's no pain. Most of the patients can tolerate it easily.
And what happens after the session once the patient is done with the treatment?
We can send the patient home, there's no problem as such. If any problem comes, the patient can contact us, and usually we call the patient after a day or two for a follow-up dressing, and usually two or three visits are necessitated, and after that patient is can be left on his or her own.
Can the entire procedure be done in one sitting?
We normally recommend 2000 to 2500 grafts a session. We can also do mega sessions, but that is if the patient really demands it. Otherwise, we are everybody is more comfortable with 2000 to 2500 grafts.
Can they comb their hair? Do they need a haircut, or would the hair grow back?
After a hair transplant, the transplanted hair, they are like normal hair. You will need to have a cut, and you can style them according to your wishes. You can wash them according to your wishes, and the transplanted hair are more robust than the normal hair that you have on your scalp.
Okay, so one more question. Can you do a hair transplant anywhere else except for the scalp?
Yeah, we can also cover bald spots in the eyebrows, and some people want thicker eyelashes, you can also do that. Or a poor beard or mustache area, which has nowadays become a fashion statement, can also be covered up by hair transplants.
How long does the procedure take when we are doing it at a go?
Normally, if you are doing 2000 to 2500 grafts in a session, which is the normal what we do, it takes around 5 to 6 hours, depending upon the technique used and the other small factors, nothing more.
Okay. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot.